This is a 981 Boxster S. It has a 3.4 liter flat six with 325 horsepower and a manual transmission. This is not a vehicle known for getting good gas mileage, but I'm going to show you how you can get 60 miles per gallon. Now, this is a bit of a parlor trick if you live in the flatlands, but if you live where there's a lot of hills, it's going to show you some techniques you can use. And even if you live in the flatlands, it'll show you a thing or two about cars that you may not have known. Most people don't understand the difference between coasting downhill and being in neutral. Let me explain. So the way 98% of Americans drive is when they get in the car, they take it out of park and put it in drive, and they stay in drive till they get to where they're going and they put it in park. That's because only 2% of cars in America are manual transmissions. So, the difference is, when your car is in drive and you're going downhill, you take your foot off the gas, but the engine is still going. The engine is acting as a brake. When you're going downhill, you still have to put on a little gas to keep up your speed. And that's because the engine has all kinds of resistance in it. If you've ever taken an auto shop class, which isn't very common anymore, but I took one. If you try to hand crank an engine, it is really difficult. There are a lot of moving parts and they have a lot of resistance. And that resistance requires gas. Now, on the other hand, when you put the car in neutral, it disconnects the wheels from the engine entirely. If you're in neutral and goose the gas, all it does is go woo, and nothing else happens. That's because the engine is disconnected. So there is a huge difference when it comes to gas mileage between coasting downhill in gear and being in neutral and gliding down the hill. The difference is you're not requiring gas for all the internal friction losses of the engine. So, what can you do with this? If you're somewhere where it's hilly, what you can do is drive to the top of the hill, then put it in neutral and glide down the hill. When your speed drops below some unacceptable level, put it back in gear and use the engine to speed up. Now, this is not something you can really do in an automatic transmission. The issue is some automatic transmissions, when you go from neutral to drive, they start off in gear one, which can rip the transmission to shreds if you're going 70 miles an hour. So this is only something you can do in a manual transmission. And now you might say, well, you could get even better mileage by shutting the engine off completely. Now that would work awesome in a 1950s classic pickup truck where there's nothing electronic, there's no steering column lock, there's no power brakes, there's no power steering. But in a modern manual transmission car, you do not want to turn the engine off when you're going 70 miles an hour. Not unless you want your family to read about you in the paper tomorrow. So leave the engine on. So over the last 35 miles, I've averaged nearly 60 miles per gallon and 66 miles an hour. Pretty damn good. So what I do is something I call goose and glide. I'll goose the gas a little if it's flat or uphill, and then I'll put it in neutral and glide. So goose and glide, goose and glide. This can be really fun. The practice your RPM matching. What I mean by that is make it so that when you go from neutral into sixth gear, that your RPM does not change. So you know what your RPM should be at a given speed in sixth gear. You give it a little gas to get to that RPM before you let the clutch out. That's actually a really good skill to have, and it's good to practice.
Thanks for watching. How feeders ain't.